So what's the difference between net income and cash flow from operating activities? Net income is a company's profit according to the accrual basis of accounting. Cash flow from operating activities, aka operating cash flow, is a company's profit after removing the effects of accrual accounting. Thus, you could view net income as a company's accrual basis profit and operating cash flow as a company's cash basis profit. But what does accrual basis profit even mean? It means that net income increases when revenues are earned and decreases when expenses are incurred, not necessarily when cash changes hands. In other words, cash coming in or out has no effect on a company's net income. Thus, if you see a company have $5 billion of net income during a period, this does not mean that the company's cash balance increased by $5 billion, and it does not mean that the company had a cash profit of $5 billion. To find the cash generated by a company's operations, you don't go to the income statement. You go to the statement of cash flows. There are three sections of the statement of cash flows: operating, investing, and financing. But the information you want is in the top section, operating activities. Now, the operating section will be presented in one of two ways. If the company uses the direct method, it will show cash collected from customers and then subtract cash payments to suppliers, to employees, and for interest and taxes. Now, if the company uses the indirect method, the operating section will instead start with net income and then show various adjustments to undo the effects of accrual accounting. Regardless of which method is used, you get the same figure for operating cash flow. The only difference is the manner in which the operating section is presented. Now, I'm going to focus primarily on the indirect method, and that's because it's used by 99% of companies, and it clearly shows the relationship between net income and operating cash flow. So how are net income and operating cash flow related? Net income is equal to revenues minus expenses. But if you take the net income figure and you remove the effects of accrual accounting, you get operating cash flow. Thus, operating cash flow can be derived from net income. Here's how it works. You take net income from the income statement, and then you subtract non-cash revenues like credit sales, which increased net income but had no effect on cash. Then you subtract cash disbursements for prepaid expenses, things like prepaid rent or prepaid insurance, where the company paid out cash but has not yet recorded an expense. Next, you add back non-cash charges like depreciation because they decreased net income but had no effect on cash. Then you add back expense accruals, which occur when a company accrued an expense, but it hasn't yet paid the cash. And finally, you add cash receipts from operating activities that weren't included in revenue. This can include cash collected from services not yet performed, or cash collected from a prior period's credit sale. The result of all these adjustments to net income is operating cash flow, which is the difference between cash receipts from operating activities and cash payments for operating activities. And you can find a detailed reconciliation in the operating section of the statement of cash flows. It usually looks something like this. Now you might be wondering, can a company post net income and accrual basis profit and yet have negative operating cash flow? Or conversely, can a company post a net loss and yet have positive operating cash flow? The answer to both these questions is yes. Pinterest, for example, posted a net loss of $128 million in 2020. Yet Pinterest had $28 million of positive operating cash flow during that same time period. The main reason for the discrepancy? Pinterest relied heavily on share-based compensation to pay its employees. This reduced Pinterest's net income in 2020, but had no effect on its cash flow. Thus, share-based compensation was added back to Pinterest's net income when calculating its operating cash flow. Now, how about a company with an accrual basis profit, net income, and negative operating cash flow? For this, we can look at Netflix in 2019. Netflix posted net income of $1.8 billion, yet operating cash flow of negative $2.8 billion. That's a difference of nearly $5 billion. So what accounts for this? It has to do with the line item additions to streaming content assets. When Netflix pays to license content or to produce its own content, Netflix capitalizes that cost, making it an asset. Thus, while Netflix spent $13.9 billion of cash on content in 2019, it did not immediately expense $13.9 billion. Instead, Netflix expensed this amount over a period of several years through amortization. And that's why you see the line item, amortization of streaming content assets, being added back to net income. Amortization is a non-cash charge that reduced net income but had no effect on cash flow. The effect on operating cash flow was the $13.9 billion that Netflix spent to license or produce content. So now that you know that a company could have net income and yet have negative operating cash flow, or the company could have a net loss and yet positive operating cash flow, you might be wondering, which is a better measure of a company's performance, net income or operating cash flow? There's no easy answer to this. You'll hear more about net income because it's the basis for calculating earnings per share, which is the most widely talked about metric in the financial news. Analysts pay a lot of attention to earnings. Did the company meet its earnings target? What's the company's price to earnings ratio? And so forth. Thus, it's tempting to overlook operating cash flow. But remember, a company's net income, and thus its earnings per share, is the result of accruals. And accruals are affected by managers' judgment, estimates, and in some cases, manipulation. Thus, it's best to evaluate both the company's net income and its operating cash flow, and to understand any discrepancies between the two.